All right, so in this video, I want to go over some easy ways to navigate through a spreadsheet. Primarily, I'm going to be talking about this name box, which is currently a new feature. If you're familiar with Excel name box, it's pretty much the same thing. So the first thing, if you want to navigate to an Excel cell and you have a larger spreadsheet, the name box will let you navigate to it really easy. All you have to do, just click in this box, type the cell where you want to go to. So let's say I want to navigate through B1000 cell. So I just type B1000 right in this box, hit enter, and that should see take me to that particular cell in my spreadsheet right away. And that's pretty much how this thing works. So you can navigate to different cells. You can also highlight a whole range if you wanted to. So let's say I wanted to select this G column from the second row up to this row 1000, right? So all I have to do, just go here and type G2 colon G1000, hit enter, and that should highlight that entire range. Just to give you a smaller example so you can actually visually see what's going on here. If I go here and type G4 colon G15, something like that, hit enter, see from G4 through G15, that area basically gets highlighted. You can also use this to navigate to different worksheets in a similar fashion. So let's say I had another worksheet over here. This is called sheet 5. Then if I wanted to go to that worksheet to a particular cell, I could just go to this name box, do something like sheet 5, which is the name of that other worksheet in this particular case, and then do exclamation sign, and then follow it by the actual cell where I want to go to. So let's say B7. So that's sheet 5 exclamation B7. If I hit enter, see, that takes me to B7 cell in worksheet. That's called sheet 5. You can also use this feature to define named ranges. If you're familiar with named ranges in general, you probably know them. When you highlight a range, right click maybe, and then here, see, define named range. That used to be the way to do this. Now we can do that a little faster. So if I wanna give a particular range, a particular name, I just highlight the area, go to this box. See, currently it says G2 through G18, which is our highlighted area. Just go in the box and give this a name. So I'm gonna call this sales or something. So this is gonna be the name. So if I'd enter, that will now create a new named range called sales, which means if I wanted to sum these numbers, I should be able to do equal sum, open parentheses, and then type the range name, sales, close parentheses, and hit enter, and that should sum up, see, it highlights those cells in the background, those basically cells, just like that. You should also be able to navigate to that named range by simply typing the name right here. So if I type sales in the box, hit enter, that should see highlight the named range. And that should also happen if I'm in a different worksheet right here and go here and type sales, hit enter. See, it brings me to this worksheet to that particular named range selected. All those defined names, so let's just do another one. I'm gonna call this reps. All these names that we define are gonna live in this named range box. So if I open this dropdown, see those names are automatically appearing here. This is reps, this is sales, and it kind of shows where the range points to. And these are our other worksheets, sheet 6, sheet 7. So again, if I click on reps, it will highlight reps. If I go click on sales, it would highlight sales, pretty much like that. One other thing that's probably worth to mention, if I decide to change the sales range, right now it goes from G2 through G18. So I'm gonna highlight something longer than that and go here and type sales again, hit enter. You'll see that it jumps back to the previous one. If I go check sales, it's still the old range. So you cannot override an existing name if you already have one. So what you have to do in those cases, just change the actual range. So you could just go in here in the dropdown, click on this manage named ranges, and that should pop up this. Now you could say, okay, this should go until not 18, but let's say 23. That's actually not the correct one. See, it says the named range. I'm gonna cancel that one and go to the one that we actually want to modify. This is it. And this is where I would do 23. Just like that, done. So now that should be modified. If I go here and open sales, see, it will highlight the new range. You can also go to the same area again by going to this dropdown, manage named ranges. And then in this area, you could also delete this thing. So if I don't want to have this anymore, I can just click on this little delete icon, remove, delete icon, remove. And that should get rid of those named ranges from here. As you can see, they're gone. So finally, I'm gonna talk about a few shortcuts also to navigate through a data set like this. And that would be some control or command shortcuts, depending if you're on a Mac or not a Mac. So if I'm in this cell on top and I click control, or if you're on a Mac, everything I say control is gonna be command. So if I press that and do down arrow key on my keyboard, see, jumps all the way down to the bottom of this particular range of cells. If I do command up or control up, I get back to the top of this. And then I can do again control or command right, that goes to this cell to the right. And if I go left and down while I have command pressed, you'll see it went all the way down to the last row and last cell in that A column. Command up, we're back to our worksheet, and command up, we're back to the top. So what this is actually doing, it finds the next blank or non-blank cell, depending where you are located at that point. So to give you an example, if I have some empty cells right in here, if I go to the top here and do command down or control down, it goes until it hits a blank cell and it stops. And then the next time if I do this, because the next cell is blank, it's gonna keep going until it finds something that's not blank and it's gonna stop. So if I do control down or command down again, you see it goes to this cell and it stops. And then the next time it's gonna find a blank cell again and it's gonna stop. See, here we go. And then finally, after this, there's nothing else. So it's gonna keep going until it hits the end of the entire spreadsheet. So again, command up, up, up. Get back to the top. You can also use the same trick going right, right to the last column, left, left. We're back to this particular area. If you combine this command up, down, left, right with shift, you can also select the cells as you're jumping. So if I'm in this top cell, I do control shift or command shift down. See, it highlights until the blank. I do it again. It goes until the next non-blank cell. And then again, it goes until the next blank. And it's pretty much gonna stop just like that. And then you could do control shift right or command shift right to select this entire area. So I'm gonna get back to the top, command up left to get back to the top here. So again, sometimes, see, because of this blanks, because it's so much tougher to select this. Now I only have just one blank, so it's not a big deal. But if you have a lot of them, this command shift down may not get you there. So this is where you can use this box right here on top. So if I want to, for example, select this D column, I can see that the last row is 1,650. So I can just go in here and do D2, D1,650, hit enter, and that should just highlight that entire area. So if I just check, see, it starts from here and it goes all the way down to the bottom of this. And we should be able to also do open references here. So if I do D2 colon D, see what it does? It goes from the top and it basically finds where the last line in the spreadsheet is, and it goes all the way down. And that's the name box. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.